Hi everyone, today we are going to talk about how to choose a physiotherapist. I have developed this presentation only for the purpose like people find difficulty in choosing up a good physiotherapy clinic or a good physiotherapist, and what are the qualities or like how they can easily choose a good physiotherapist. I will just try to explain with the help of this video. This video is solely for educational purposes, okay? And if you have any question regarding any of the things that I am explaining in the video, then you can ask in the comment section over here. The first thing that an individual needs to look is the qualification of a physiotherapist. There are two programs going on primarily for physiotherapy in India. One is an undergraduate program that we call as Bachelor of Physiotherapy, and second is postgraduate program that is known as Master of Physiotherapy. So physiotherapists are generally very open to share their education qualification, so anyone can ask about that, and those physiotherapists who are running their clinic, they usually share this thing over their website as well. Now the second most important thing that an individual needs to look when he or she is just trying to choose a physiotherapist is their specialization. So primarily there are four specialization courses are offered in post-graduation level. One is MPT in orthopedics, second is an MPT in neurology, third is MPT in sports, and fourth is MPT in cardiorespiratory physiotherapy. The people who study abroad, they have more specializations available, like in pediatrics, in gynecology, and in other fields as well. So if an individual is having a neurospecific problem, he can visit to any physiotherapist, but if he'll visit a specialized physiotherapist who has done MPT in neurology, he will be having an explicit skill and an extra tool to help the individual out from their problem. Now the third most important thing is work experience. Everyone knows like experience enriches your knowledge, upgrades your skill, and sharpens the saw. So basically, if an individual is working in a good organization or has worked in a good organization, it teaches them a lot. It goes like the same with physiotherapist as well. So if an individual has worked in good organization, it will be reflected in their CV, in their profile, which they usually share on the website, in the clinics portal, and things like that. So work experience is the key. 3 to 5 years of experience is generally considered as very good. And it's not a matter of number of years, it's a matter like how many patients do you see per day, that makes you more experienced. So people like who are like 1 year experience, sometimes they have a good number of patient experience, so they are also equally good if you'll compare them to 3 or 4 year experience. So it's not a matter of year, it's like how much you are exposed to patient and how many patients you have helped out with your skills. Now another very important thing about which an individual should think when they are choosing a physiotherapist. So there are primarily three domains of physiotherapy, and people usually practice either with a very specific domain or with a holistic approach. I generally advise an individual to meet a physiotherapist like who works on a holistic approach, because one single tool cannot fix all the problem of all the individual. So primarily there are three domains of physiotherapy. One is exercise therapy, in which the individual is guided by a physiotherapist to perform therapeutic exercises under supervision and some exercises at home as a home exercise program to improve and upgrade the status of their problem. Second is manual therapy. In manual therapy, we are using our hands to mobilize the joint, to manipulate the joint, to work on flexibility of the muscle, to work on overactivity or underactivity of a particular muscle. We just try to correct the movement dysfunction with the help of manual therapy. And third is electrotherapy, in which we are using electronic gadgets to calm down the pain and to check the feedback of the individual, how the individual was doing an activity before, how the individual was doing the activity after the treatment. So in electrotherapy, there are two things. One is like a therapeutic thing, and second is like a biofeedback thing that can be addressed with the help of electrotherapy. Now the next very important point is how the practice is maintained at their respective clinic or in their respective hospital or in their respective treatment settings. So primarily there are two types of
practice that is going on in physiotherapy. One is individual specific, second is group specific. In individual specific physiotherapy treatment, one patient is treated at one time. It's usually like a fixed duration treatment session, which could be half an hour, 45 minutes or 1 hour. Schedule appointments are generally recommended for these kind of places because they prefer in quality, and if your treatment time is compromised because of your arrival time or because of the therapist availability, it gets your treatment outcome gets compromised to some extent. These kind of physiotherapy treatment are generally a bit costly, but it is cost effective. Group specific physiotherapy is multiple patients are seen at a time. One individual therapist is attending 2 to 3 patients depending upon the setup, and the patients are sitting there in line like an OPD, and the treatment time may vary on different days depending upon the patient load. This treatment is less costly, but the productivity is compromised to some extent because of the availability of time and attention of the physiotherapist. So any individual can pick any of this depending upon their preference. So both the treatments are effective. Now the most important thing that an individual should rely on is patient experience and patient satisfaction. Now how you can get to know like the patient experience and patient satisfaction? Nowadays we are looking for everything on Google. We are searching a lot of things on Google, and Google has now given a facility for reviews. Like if an individual has a good experience of any restaurant, any place, not a clinic per se, they give a review option as well, like how did you find that place, and they ask multiple questions, like sometimes they ask for photos, sometimes they ask about like what was the facility like. And if someone can go through a Google review of a particular clinic or a particular physiotherapist, they can see like if they have helped someone else with the similar problem, or like how is the entire level of satisfaction amongst the patient that they have seen. So not everyone is giving Google reviews, but a lot of people are giving reviews. So you can just see like if 10 individuals is visiting a clinic in a day, so not everyone is allowed to give review, or not everyone is giving review on a particular day. Usually people give review at the end of their treatment, it's like one individual can give only one Google review. So Google reviews are quite authentic, and sometimes like people display the patient reviews on their website as well. So an individual can go and check their website as well to see like what helps them more. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any comments in our suggestion, then you can just write down in the comment box over here. We'll try to add on in our next video as well.
Hi everyone, today we are going to talk about how to choose